Welcome back to The Generation Y. You're with me, Scott Sunjata Keita. We are talking about young people in political participation. Are young people really political apathetic? Is it by design or is it by default? And to discuss that with me is Mr. Felix Kipkalia, the Director General of the Youth Senate, and also an entrepreneur. What a surprise. Mr. Felix, now, before you went on break, you had mentioned the Youth Senate, what it does, but what structure exists to make sure that Youth Senate as a function, it reaches out there to the roots, to the young people out there in the counties? What structure have you set up in place?
We have a very robust structure. Mm-hmm. We have a president, then the president is deputized by two, the head of operations and head of programs. Then after that, we have thematic areas that we have actually focused on as the Youth Senate, the mm-hmm. health, agribusiness. We have health, agribusiness, entrepreneurship, education. These are among the thematic areas that we actually want to impact the youth. Below them, we have the directors who are in charge of the secretariat in charge of the daily operation of the Youth Senate. Uh-huh. And then we have the junior senators.
Amazing.
We have 47 junior senators all over the country. Each and every county, we have a junior senator representing Youth Senate on the ground. Uh-huh. Then the junior senators, we gave them a mandate to give us the sub-county representatives. Uh-huh. That means it's the constituency level. Then below them, they have opinion leaders. Each of them, we gave them a mandate of getting at least 20 mm-hmm. opinion leaders down there. Mm-hmm. So as you can see, it's very robust.
Yeah.
You can imagine from the national office, you have the junior senator. Then the junior senator himself or herself has a team, a secretariat team on mm-hmm. the county.
Mm-hmm.
We call them county development boards.
Mm-hmm.
And then below them, we have the sub-county representatives.
Mm-hmm.
And then we have 20 on each sub-county representative.
Wow, that's a huge number.
As we speak right now, we are having around 240,000
wow.
members and counting. We have an online platform that you can get to our website, you can just log in and be a member.
Mm-hmm.
So we have members of around 240,000 as we speak, and it's still counting. We're still recruiting more and more.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so that is the structure we have on trying to get to the root, to the grassroots.
Yeah, amazing. And how do you keep it active? How do you ensure that every stage of the organization is active and it engages with young people?
Yeah, we usually have reports, monthly reports from every... they report to the dockets. For instance, if it's health,
mm-hmm.
if this month, this is how we have structured. Every month we have it's a thematic month.
Mm-hmm.
Last month, the month that we had the International Youth Day,
mm-hmm.
it was things to do with youth empowerment,
yeah.
entrepreneurship to be specific, because it was around the area, the time that
the Global
Obama,
Entrepreneurship Summit,
the
GES
was
yeah,
here.
Yeah.
So we focused on that. The mm-hmm. whole of that, we did a pre-GES summit
mm-hmm.
in Kiambu County,
amazing,
in Machakos County, mm-hmm. and we were to do one in Nakuru County, but there was a hitch with some of our sponsors.
Mm-hmm.
But then we didn't stop there, we're still moving on. So after we do those things, those kind of programs,
mm-hmm.
the involved officials mm-hmm. report back to the office, and we actually
yeah.
see, because you know, at the end of it all, we look at the evaluations and monitoring.
Wow.
Are
yeah.
these people actually
yeah.
getting what they're supposed to be getting?
Are they getting value for their
time to come and listen to you?
It's true.
Yeah. So at the end of it all is the impact you're having on the ground. That is
mm-hmm.
what we are objective.
Mm-hmm.
If we say we want to train 80,000 youth by
mm-hmm.
the end of this year.
Mm-hmm.
By the time we get into December,
mm-hmm.
before we go to Christmas,
mm-hmm.
we have to ascertain that even if we didn't get to 80,000,
mm-hmm.
we are here
mm-hmm.
and we are moving forward.
Yeah.
And we are actually having them on the database. We give them this job, the Tuco Works that we are partnering with the Microsoft and Rockefeller Foundation.
Yeah.
We give them these jobs. We try to see how they are faring on.
Mm-hmm.
Once in a while, we do the follow-ups. We call the, you know, we get their contacts. We do the follow-ups. We can converge in. If it's Nakuru County, we convert
mm-hmm.
in Nakuru.
Yeah.
We get to know what is actually happening.
Yeah.
Are you really getting? Are you really? Is it really beneficial to you? Because at the end of it all, the concept, if it's not beneficial to the grassroots guys, it's not viable.
It's not working at
yeah.
all. Yeah. So and working with, of course, the grassroots young people out there,
mm-hmm.
Training them on entrepreneurship, agribusiness,
mm-hmm.
and education. Have you identified some, say, talents out there, say in entrepreneurship, in whatever kind of category that you think are worth mentioning for, especially in regard to young people just coming up to solve?
We've actually had a lot of, as we speak also, we also have, there's a program we're doing, so we're bringing on Bahati.
Mm-hmm. Bahati the musician.
Bahati the musician.
Amazing stuff.
On the issue of the talent search.
Yeah? Mm-hmm.
We're also doing it to hit two birds with one stone.
Mm.
We wanted to also do some kind of drug and abuse, a campaign against drug abuse. Mm-hmm. So he wanted to have him as our ambassador. Wow. And the program is coming up.
Wow.
We're just finalizing.
Amazing.
And he's the person who's going to be helping us on issues to do with talent search and trying to get these youth come out, show your potential.
Exactly.
Yeah? Unlock your potential outside. In entrepreneurship, I would love to say we have some success stories that we have.
Mm-hmm.
For one, myself.
Amazing, of course.
I've had a journey on entrepreneurship.
Yeah.
Besides me, there are several other people in the Youth Senate.
Mm-hmm.
And besides the Youth Senate, we have individual groups who've actually helped them unlock that what they really wanted to do.
Amazing.
Yeah, I also mentioned some of the ones that I can remember. We have a lot, but the name that I can remember is Sarah Kagoya.
Uh-huh.
She's from Trans Nzoia,
mm-hmm.
and she's been doing something to do with bottling of water,
wow.
the supplying water.
Mm-hmm.
So she had a challenge in getting the initial capital. We brought her on board. We tried to help her secure the funds from the youth fund, from this fund, the seed money that we have.
Mm.
So it's the business is doing well as we speak, and I think
so. There's a lot of potential out there.
A lot of potential.
Amazing stuff. But looking at that again, right now in the current situation, from alcoholism to addiction to lack of employment, what are some of those harsh challenges that you guys have identified working with the grassroots youths out there?
Okay, the biggest challenge that we have, you know the name Youth Senate?
Youth Senate.
People take it as if it's a political wing for some politicians.
Uh-huh. So it's not a political wing?
It is not a political wing. It is not politically affiliated.
Mm-hmm.
It is something that only focuses on the youth advocacy and empowerment.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so the challenge that we've been having is when we go down there and we say we're the Youth Senate, people come expecting that you from the government, from a politician, they expect handouts from the youth.
Because that's how it's done.
That's how it's done by the politicians.
Yeah.
So for us to start convincing them that we are not political, this is what we have brought to you before we
it's
get
a process.
That goodwill.
It's a process.
It's a process. And that it is actually, we are taking more time to finish something that we would have done within 3 months, we'll take 6 months because we need to have that period of convincing them first that this thing that we're bringing, we're not giving you fish, we're teaching you how to fish.
Mm-hmm.
So that is one of the challenges that we're having.
Mm-hmm.
But then just to clarify, we call it Youth Senate because Senate, what is the meaning of Senate? It's just a convention.
Mm-hmm.
And a Youth Senate is a convention of the young people who feel together we can stand and we can actually bargain and get more for ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Amazing stuff. Now, what is the process of, say, someone out there who wants to be part of the Youth Senate? What process should they follow?
Okay. When we have a website,
mm-hmm.
www.youthsenate.or.ke. Once you just go, it is user-friendly. We have tried by all, because our focus is on the youth and getting down to the grassroots.
Mm.
And it's a fact that majority of the youth are actually on the grassroots.
Mm-hmm.
And some of them are not so good in terms of computer.
Mm-hmm.
Some of them don't even have the Android phones. But then it's for now, we are working on getting offices in the county. We want to partner with the county governments to get an office, at least in the county headquarters, we can have an office for the Youth Senate. If we can be able to partner with them.
Mm-hmm.
And that will be for the guys who cannot access the internet or the phone or the computer.
Mm-hmm.
But for the rest of the people who can access the website, the internet,
mm-hmm.
we just go to the website, then there's a member login, there's a member registration.
Mm-hmm.
You just register, and then once we get your details, we will be communicating to you all the programs that we have.
Uh-huh.
If you can be able to attend, you can always come and attend.
Mm-hmm.
And just to mention, we're also working on partnering with KQ, partnering with Nakumat, Taskil, all those outlets. We want to partner with them so that if they're having a product that wants to go out there, we can have our people getting it first, the members in the Youth Senate, that this product is coming up.
So there's an added advantage for being a member of the Youth Senate.
If you're going for the KQ, after we do the partnership and sign the MOU, if you're flying with KQ, you'll have some kind of...
I'm looking forward myself to be a member of the Youth Senate, I mean. Well, you're going to take another short break. You're watching The Generation Y with me, Scott Njeta-Keita. We will be right back.